Today we're going to get the $8 US Wyze Bulb all set up, but I'm also going to show you how to take it a little bit further and get it integrated with a couple of different systems. So let's get going. Hello automators, thanks for tuning in again. I'm Brian from Automate Your Life, and today I'm going to take the frustration out of automation by giving you all the tips and tricks into getting your Wyze Bulb set up, and I'll make sure that some of the pitfalls that you will run into with these bulbs will be avoided. Now, you'll need the Wyze application on an iOS or an Android device, and you'll need to be connected to a 2.4 Wi-Fi signal in your home or a network in your home. Now, once you've done that, you can go ahead and go into the Wyze application, and from there you're going to want to reset the light. So this is my Wyze bulb here, and in order to reset the light or get it ready to pair, we want to turn on and off the switch 3 times. Now, I'm not going to leave this on much, but you can see it kind of flash there from a yellower color to the whiter color, and it will sit here and do this for a little bit while it's ready to basically pair in the application. Now, I'm going to move to the application and we'll get that done. Inside of the application, I'm just going to start a recording here, and up in the top right are 3 dots, and you're going to hit add a product. Now, once you've done that, you can see the Wyze bulb choice at the bottom. Now, if you don't see that, your app is not up to date. You'll need to update your application. You can see that they're telling you right here to power cycle your bulb, but we've already done that, so I'm just going to hit next. Now, this is why you're connected to your 2.4 gigahertz Wi-Fi network already when you go into the application, because it pre-fills the network, and you'll have to probably put in your password here for your Wi-Fi network. If you don't, if it's already filled out, you're like me and you've set up some previous products inside of the Wyze application. Now, what they want me to do is go to my Wi-Fi settings. So I'm just going to move over in my phone. I've went to my settings and I go into the Wi-Fi system, and what you'll notice is somewhere down there, and if you're setting up multiple of these, you can have them on the same switch and you will actually see all three, and you just repeat this process multiple times without the reset. Actually, you don't have to reset the bulbs, because then you would reset them again. So what you're going to do is click on that or tap on that, and it will connect physically to that network. Now, when we head back to the Wyze application, it instantly moves forward. If it didn't, you'd have a next button there, but it's instantly moved forward into the connection process. So it's trying to connect my cell phone basically to the bulb, and then the bulb to put it onto our Wi-Fi. So there's a transfer of information going on here. So what you're going to do is enter in a device name. Now, I'm just going to call this our tester bulb for right now, because that's what it is for me in my home right now. Now I just hit the finish setup button and we're all done with the initial setup. Now, just so it doesn't blind you, I'm gonna leave it off to the side here for a little bit, but within the application, I can hit an on and an off and the bulb will respond to that. So you can see as I hit that, that's it. It's as hard as it gets. I can also tap in and you will notice that you will get an upgrade option here right away in terms of a new firmware. And if you don't get that, that's okay. Your bulb has been updated all the way. Now, what I'm going to do next is just run you through a demonstration of how the different color profiles work when you go into the actual menu on the bulb. Let's start off just by turning on the bulb with the little radio button up at the top right. You can see it's on its most yellow setting or yellow light setting, and it's also at brightness 1%. Now, as I crank it up there, that's around 100%, and it's really quite a bright bulb, over 800 lumens as specified. Now, I can go and adjust the actual temperature of the bulb here, and we're running from the 2700 to 6500K frame here, or light frame, and it really does create quite the difference in your bulbs. Now, the little time clock looking button allows you to turn on and off the lights after so many seconds, and you can also hit the add scene button to go ahead and save any of your favorite settings, and then from there you can tap that in order to
turn the bulb to that. Now, there are additional settings up in the top right when you hit the gear icon, and this brings you to the ability to rename the bulb, turn on a vacation mode, which just makes the bulbs turn on and off randomly. You also can adjust the scenes further if you'd like to change what they're set as. You can share this specific device with other accounts, and you can also get the basic info and run a firmware upgrade if you're wanting to check on that.
Now that we have the basics down and we're able to change the color and the brightness on the light, let's get a little bit deeper. And throughout this video, you're going to find us get deeper and deeper and deeper. But what we're going to do first off is hit those three dots at the top, and we're going to go to edit shortcuts. And I'm going to scroll down to the bottom. I have quite a few, and I'm going to hit the create shortcut button. Now, I want to create an action. So this is what I want the bulb to do in a specific moment. And we'll deal with that specific moment after. Now, I can hit new action, and here's the tester bulb, and I'm going to tap on that. Now, within this one action, I'm going to hit turn on, set brightness, and set color temperature. You don't have to do all of those things, but those are all the things I want to do at the same time. Now, I'm going to turn the brightness way down. I can pick a white, but I'm going to choose the soft white here, and then I'm going to hit save. Now, you can see it created three separate actions, but I just did that in one. Now I hit done, and I'm back at this create shortcut screen. Now I could leave this as just a shortcut button with a name, and I'm going to call this name tester bulb on, but I can also automate that function. So if I tap that little radio button, here's my automation choices. So I could choose to turn on and off the bulbs. You could see how you could make two of these shortcuts, and I could turn them all on and off at specific times. That's good enough for many people, but let's go a little bit deeper. I'm going to hit the event, and now I have access to everything inside of the Wyze application. So this is cameras. You can see my garage camera down at the bottom. I also have these different motion detectors, and I can use those to trigger events. I could also use other bulbs. So if you kind of wanted to set these in a series, or basically have one trigger the rest of them, you can do that as well. Now, what I'm going to do is I have a Wyze Sense contact sensor sitting here. You can have a look at it right there. Now, this contact sensor it's called the secret event sensor, and I'm going to tap on that.
Now, this is very simple. We just hit the opens button. We could choose other options here, and that sets our event. So you can go ahead now, and every time you open that sensor, it will trigger those three actions that we set up.
Now, what I did here in a short break is I just added a second shortcut that when this closes, this bulb will turn off. So there we go, we're open and the bulb turns on. And now as I put it back together, the bulb turns off. You can see how quick that actually is, that action. You could also set delays there once they've been closed for say a minute. You could have this turn off. So that pretty much gets you to the point where you can utilize the application fully. You can obviously do different setups here, but you're ready to go on to the next most complex thing, which is moving to if this then that.
On the IFTTT.com website, you're going to want to start with a creation of an applet. Now, if this, and we tap on that, this, you go ahead and you could choose Wyze to start the actual automation, but today, because we're triggering bulbs on, I'm going to use a platform like Samsung SmartThings. Now, if you don't have either of these services connected, then it will ask you to put in your username and password for those. Now, you can see all these different choices that we have access to, but I'm going to use a motion sensor to trigger. So I'm going to use my new bathroom sensor and create that trigger. Then I'm going to hit that portion of the applet and type in Wyze, go into there, and now I can turn my bulb on. Now you'll want to create the reverse applet of this to turn the bulb off after the motion detector has stopped sensing motion. In SmartThings, you have to do something a little more complex than that, usually with motion detectors, but for now, we'll leave this, and I'll show you in a later video how to really integrate SmartThings and Wyze.
So now that we're done that, we're going to move into integration with these two products. So Google Google Home Hub over here, or any Google Home product, as well as the Amazon Echo or their voice assistant. So we can get these bulbs connected and working with those, and then we can use our voice to control. Now, if you've never connected a Wyze product at all to your voice assistant, well, then let me show you how to do that very quickly.
Inside of Amazon's voice assistant application, you'll go into skills and games from the menu. You'll hit the search icon at the top right, and then you'll type in Wyze. Inside of there, you will find the skill, and right here it will say enable skill, and you'll tap on that in order to put in your Wyze credentials. Inside of Google Home's application, you're going to hit the add button, set up device, have something already set up, and again search for Wyze, tap on that, and put in your credentials.
If you've previously connected the Wyze service, well, it's actually a lot easier to get these devices to come in and into the voice assistant platforms here. So I can say, sync my devices.
Okay, syncing devices for 11 providers.
And with Amazon's voice assistant, discover my devices.
Starting discovery.
Now, both of these have synchronized, and I could go add them to the different rooms. That's a very simple process here, but for now, I'm just going to show you that you can turn on and off with your voice assistant. So, turn on tester bulb.
You got it, turning tester bulb on. Sure, setting tester bulb brightness to 1%.
Turn off tester bulb. So there you go, you can do everything now with your Wyze bulbs. You're gonna get a ton of functionality out of those bulbs. And if you're looking for some more ideas for how to utilize Wyze Sense, Wyze Cameras with your Wyze bulbs, well, I've created a special playlist here for getting the most out of your Wyze bulbs. And that playlist is on screen right now. So go ahead and watch that. Otherwise, guys, don't hate, automate.